You're obviously handsome. Do you think there are disadvantages of being too handsome?
Sorry, say
again. Do you think there are disadvantages of being too handsome?
Sorry.
Disadvantages of being too
disadvantages.
Handsome.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. No, I mean, I don't think there would be any direct disadvantages apart from like maybe some stereotypes or the fact that people wouldn't necessarily focus on other aspects of your personality, you know? Clearly, like, it's a very common thing to judge people from the appearance, and we can't help it. I mean, it's obvious that you know, if someone, you know, to you looks good, you're more prone to, like, you know, be talkative to them or to approach them or whatever. So, and maybe, like, when that happens, you overlook other things, you know? Like, obviously, with me, like, I always, at the beginning of my academic career, for example, I wanted to keep secret the fact that I was a model, because I felt like people in academia would look down on that. Only by growing up and maturing, you learn how to embrace every aspect of your life, and really see that that is amazing, that you can do two things that are so different, you know? Exploit a talent that otherwise wouldn't be exploited in the academia at all. So sometimes it happens that, you know, people, you know, they see me and they assume things. You know, the last thing they would think is that I am PhD, for example. I mean, still now people have a problem, like, addressing me as doctor, you know? Like, I go to the bank and they see on the envelope, Dr. Boselli, say, like, oh, sir, this appears to be a mistake, a typo. You mean Mr. Boselli, right? It's like, dude, like, you're reading it, you know? It's not like, if you call me like that, I don't mind, you know? You can call me Pietro, but if you see it written, you know? But it's funny, I feel like that wouldn't necessarily happen if, you know, like, I look like an old professor. yeah.
Are you still part ng girlfriends?
Very, ano, sa schedules.
Saan na H?